I stand here today to participate in the motion of thanks on the President's address, which has been moved by Dr. Mahesh Sharma, seconded by Sri Virendra Singh. Already around 4 hours have passed and 5 members have spoken. Initially, I would say that I am thankful to this government for remembering and going to celebrate the 10th Guru of our Dharma, Guru Gobind Singh, the 350th anniversary, and also of commemorating Sri Ramanujacharya, the social reformation that he had brought in our society. Also remembering Baksi Jagabandhu Vidyadhar, who had led an uprising in that remote part of this country in Odisha and fought against the British company soldiers for more than 30-35 years. Also remembering Banda Bahadur and also commemorating his deeds. And of course, remembering Mother Teresa for the selfless service that she has done for the downtrodden and the needy. What is India? What is Bharat that we all call? And what is our strength that the President has spoken about? What we always cherish and always feel proud of when we go outside our boundaries, national boundaries. When people look up to us and say, such a big country, so diverse, so multilingual, and yet you have a government, yet you have respective states which are led by different political parties, and yet you are prospering with such a good measure. How is it happening? And this question is not being posed by African countries, those upcoming countries who are seeing democracy in a better light today, but by those countries which have seen democracy for last many centuries, even in Europe. What is that intrinsic strength that we are talking about and we should feel proud about? That intrinsic strength, I believe, is relating to our respect for diversity, our respect for a different type of opinion, that respect which was inculcated during the freedom struggle, that yes, the other person may have a different point of view, but that view also should be respected, not only to be accepted, but also to be respected. And it is this intrinsic value which did not crop up in 20th century nationalism or 19th century nationalism. This respect is there inborn, as we call it, as Bharatiyata, that Indianness that has been there for many, many centuries. If we talk about Ashoka, if we talk since then, repeatedly in our Shastras, in our Puranas, in our thought, in every expression of our views, that respect is there, that yes, Satya ek hai, vipra bahuda vadanti, ekam satya, vipra bahuda vadanti. The path is one, but there are different roads which lead to that ultimate goal. This is the essence of our strength. And what is happening today? When somebody says, yes, this country has been bereft with danga, with caste conflict, with religious conflict, it was there when, before the advent of Islam in this country, there were different sampradayas in our country. There were Ganapatyas, there were Shaktas, there were Shaivas, there were Sanatanis, there were Vaishnavas. All were fighting against each other to have their supremacy in this society. Yet, there were Ramanujacharya who came up and say, yes, सत्य एक है, मार्ग अलग अलग हो सकता है, पर एवरी रोड लीड्स टू वन सुप्रीम बीइंग. एंड टुडे वी हैव सेग्रीगेटेड डिफरेंट रिलीजन, डिफरेंट सेक्ट्स. माई ओनली रिक्वेस्ट टू द मेंबर्स प्रेजेंट इन दिस हाउस हियर इज, डाइवर्सिटी इज द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ भारत, नॉट एक्सेप्टेंस बट रेस्पेक्ट ऑफ डाइवर्सिटी इज आवर स्ट्रेंथ. एंड कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन recognizes this, has enshrined this, and that is the basic essence of our strength. I don't know if a new parliament is going to be constructed in near future. The same advice and mantras and shlokas that are inscribed in this edifice will be replicated in that edifice or not. But many a time when I move around the corridors of this building, of this edifice, I try to understand what has been said. Those were sane words, sane sayings, which have been there for thousands of years. And even that single line which is just enshrined above you, which says, Dharma Chakra Pramartanaya. What does that signify? The eternal wheel of righteousness is what's supposed to be pursued by all of us who take pledge that we are here to serve this nation. Sir, while going through the speeches, while listening to the Honorable President the other day in the Central Hall, in the joint session of our house, while going through the written speech to find out certain points on which I should deliberate, I was really very much obliged to the Honorable President for two reasons. Of course, I have moved certain amendments, and I will be persisting to move those amendments when it will be called for. But those two instances are, one correction that has been made, and that correction is, I remember very clearly, in para 27, because this is a correction which I would say a mistake was committed 2 years ago, perhaps in 2014, the first speech, where it was mentioned Shrama Meva Jayate, and there I had said, and I mentioned about the famous king of Ramayana, Nahusa. Through his tapasya, he had attained Indrapad, was being carried in a palanquin by the pandits, by the saints of that era. And that time, out of audacity, he had said, Skandam ki badhati. तो उसके रिप्लाई में उन्होंने कहे थे स्कंदंग न बाधते राजन तब बाधती बाधते. फिजिकल पेन इज नॉट एक्चुअली द पेन, इट इज योर ग्रामेटिकल मिस्टेक दैट इज एक्चुअली पेनिंग अस, पुटिंग अस इन पेन. स्कंदंग न बाधते राजन तब बाधती बाधते, एटलीस्ट दैट टाइम आई हैड मेंशनड करेक्टेड, एंड आई एम थैंकफुल टू द गवर्नमेंट दैट दे हैव करेक्टेड इट एंड हैव सेड श्रमेव जयते instead of Shrama Meva Jayate. That was grammatically wrong. That's a good correction. It is better when some mistakes have been pointed out, or it dawns on you that there is a mistake, you correct it. That's the way how a person progresses, and how a government also progresses, how a society also progresses. And I'm also equally thankful to this government, which has recognized, and I'm thankful to the Prime Minister, who also, in his speech last year or year before last, had mentioned very categorically about the speech of Tathagat Satpathy, my colleague of my party, when he had said, why should we be forced to learn Hindi? Why not Tamil? Why not Malayalam? Why not a person from Hindi heartland also learn Odia? to which the Prime Minister in his reply had said, this is a very good idea. The oneness of this country can also develop if all of us, with this multilingual facility that is available today, why can't students of Kashmir come to Tamil Nadu and learn Tamil, stay there for 2 months and understand their culture, their civilization?
No, please, not allowed.
Similarly, and that is the reason why a mention has been made about Ek Bharat, Shrestha Bharat. And this program has been inculcated and it finds place in the President's speech. The idea was one of our members of this House. Idea was accepted by the Honorable Prime Minister and it finds reflection in this speech of Honorable President. These are the two good words which I have spoken in favor of this speech. I would come to the pain that we are feeling, the pain that is in our heart, the pain in which our Chief Minister has spoken, I will fight till the last breath that is in me. That pain is in with all Odias today because of Mahanadi, because of the treacherous way in which Chhattisgarh government is operating, the manner in which the central government is putting has closed its eyes to the problem that Odisha is facing. It has closed its eyes. Though the other day the water resources minister said, Jagannath Prasare Hath. But what is happening today? That river is dying. Mahanadi, which is the Jivan Rekha. And for last 70 years, the agreements that were there, everything has been thrown to winds. A meeting was called by the water resources minister. The chief minister of Chhattisgarh and the chief minister of Odisha were present. Yes, we will sit down for discussion. Subsequently, the chief secretaries of both the states also sat down. We will sit down for discussion, for heaven's sake. Stop the construction on Mahanadi. The tributaries of Mahanadi. Stop. Don't stop the flow of water during the non-monsoon session. Our farmers are dying. Our drinking water facility is being curbed. Our production of electricity also is getting hampered. And when we come with a petition before the Supreme Court, before the Prime Minister, what is our demand? Our demand is, yes, we will sit down on the table for discussion. But first, restrict Chhattisgarh government. And what does the Water Resources Minister say? Center has no power. Isn't it your government? If it would have been the Congress government, would have also said the same thing. Isn't it your government there, which has been persistently continuing construction of these dams there and choking the flow of river water Mahanadi? Out of 30 districts, more than 15 districts get irrigation facility by Mahanadi. What is happening? And very recently, I think 2-3 weeks back, a conciliatory move was made, a committee was formed. Odisha government said, we will not participate in that discussion. Our demand is, you form a tribunal. As per the law, a tribunal has to be formed. We will accept. Let them go into those details. But I would appeal, while discussing on the motion of thanks to the Honorable President, I would appeal to the Prime Minister and to the Prime Minister alone, as our chief minister has written to him, stop construction on Mahanadi in Chhattisgarh. We will come down onto the table and discuss. Don't play politics with us. Don't play politics with us. We have witnessed a war 2,300 years ago. We didn't succumb to the mighty empire of Magath. We had large maritime activities for more than 1,500 years, continuous. We didn't succumb to the British. And the war you are going to commemorate of 1817, that was a 35-year-long war, and Bakshi Jagabandhu did not submit, did not surrender. And today, when our Chief Minister is saying, I will fight till the last breath, please understand how it has pained us and how far can we go. And we will go. And this is Biju Janata Dal which is saying this in this house. Regarding agriculture, sir, we have been hearing about Kisan, poor, and after 1991, inclusive growth, irrespective, and these three words are there in every speech. Every speech, whoever is the president, whichever is the government, Kisan, poor, and nowadays a word has been included, inclusive growth. Every government talk about this in some form or other. In para 16 and 17, the government has said through president's speech, various steps have been taken to transform the lives of our farmers. Yes, everything is being done. Yet there are farmers' suicides, migration of farm labor. Despite MGNREGA, the rural workforce is unable to have 2 square meals a day. Hunger is also rampant. And to top it all, suicides of farmers also take place. This is because of gradual pauperization of our farmers that has taken place, despite the efforts that every government, including this government, has taken. Until and unless government has, until and unless farming is made profitable, why would anyone indulge in farming? Today, it is being done only for sustenance, just to survive. Honorable President has reminded us of the Champaran Satyagraha. But first we have to understand why that Satyagraha happened. Let us remember that. And that will be a fitting tribute to those farmers who agitated against the company, against the British powers, against my dear friend, the agriculture minister, understands it. While celebrating the centenary year of Champaran Satyagraha, let us understand why the Mahatma took up the cause of indigo cultivators, and ultimately how the farmers were made free from the clutches of exploiters. And today, who is exploiting the farmers? Have we identified? Let us identify them. While we are celebrating the Champaran Satyagraha, let us identify the exploiters of farmers of today. List them. These are the people who are exploiting. Then it will be a fitting tribute, not only to the Mahatma, but also to the cause of Champaran Satyagraha. Today, exploitation of farmer is there.
Mehtabhi, recognize it. How much time do you need?
Sir, another 10 minutes.
Your right party time is... time to pura khatam ho gaya abhi.
Maine dekha tha, sir, aap jab hamare Congress ke leader ko rok rahe the.
Please. It cannot be compensated now, no? Please. प्लीज कंक्लूड.
इज द गवर्नमेंट
कॉम्पेंसेशन इज ऑलवेज कॉम्पेंसेशन इज एन वर्ड इट इज फॉर कॉम्पेंसेशन
नो लेट हिम कंटिन्यू नाउ.
थैंक यू सर. इज द गवर्नमेंट अवेयर अबाउट इट? इफ सो व्हाट स्टेप्स हैव बीन टेकन? वी डिडंट फाइंड एनीथिंग मेंशन्ड इन द स्पीच रिलेटिंग टू दिस. किसान क्रेडिट कार्ड, रुपे कार्ड, कॉर्पस ऑफ नाबार्ड विल हेल्प प्रोवाइडिंग क्रेडिट. बट क्रेडिट तो समस्या है. क्रेडिट लेके ना सूझ परिशोध ना करने पाने की ही समस्या है. बट इफ द क्रॉप इज नॉट प्रॉफिटेबल रेम्युनरेटिव व्हाट फन इट वुड बी अदर देन driving them to suicide for humiliation. During last 30 months, sir, how many times this government has increased minimum support price? I think from the Congress side somebody would say, yes, we have done it during last 10 years so many times.
It's true also.
I'm not disputing that. I don't know your leader has said that or not. I don't know whether your leader has said that or not. But how many times you have, during last 30 months, have increased the MSP, support price of paddy, support price of wheat? Okay, you have kept count. That can be found out. In para 52, sir, 2 lakh crore are being transferred to Gram Panchayats during 2015 to 2020. A tickless question is here, the short point. I'm not elaborating it. When in the late 80s, the famous constitutional amendment was done during Rajiv Gandhi's tenure, devolution of power to the panchayats, because there was some pressure from the respective state governments, total devolution could not get affected transferring the power to the Gram Panchayats or to the Jila Panchayats. That needs to be corrected. Are you prepared to doing it? You are transferring a lot of money now, and you have said more than 2 lakh crore will be transferred within a span of 5 years. Money has started reaching the panchayats. But what monitoring mechanism you have in place today? How devolution of power from the state capital to the panchayats have been affected? And this is the house where that decision has been taken. It was not taken during Rajiv Gandhi's tenure because of other things. At least a beginning was made during that time. After those 15 years and this 17 years, say 32 years, isn't it time to review? But is there anything in this speech? No. Only घोषणाएं हैं, इतना पैसा हम दे रहे हैं. एंड हियर आई एम रिमाइंडेड सर अबाउट वन थिंग. आई थिंक यू विल अंडरस्टैंड बेटर बिकॉज यू आर वेरी कन्वर्सेंट इन हिंदी एंड ऑल्सो इन इंग्लिश. वाई शुड वी ऑलवेज से दिस इज अ सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट? इज इट सेंटर? वॉट डज दैट मीन? डज सेंटर फाइंड प्लेस इन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन? इट इज द यूनियन ऑफ स्टेट्स एंड यूनियन गवर्नमेंट. And union has a different meaning. Center has a different connotation. And center means every state has to run to the center. Union means every state makes a union. And that is the true character of federalism. And repeatedly, Hindi mein kya kehte hain, aapko shayad malum hoga. Aap sangh kyun nahi kehte? Ye sangh sarkar hai, kyun nahi kehte? मुझे तो कोई समस्या नहीं है. आप यूनियन पब्लिक सर्विस कमीशन को क्या कहते हैं हिंदी में? यूनियन पब्लिक सर्विस कमीशन को क्या कहते हैं हिंदी में?
लोक सेवा.
तो ये सरकार संघ सरकार क्यों नहीं कहते? आप तो एक बिगिनिंग तो करिए. आप क्यों बार बार कह रहे हैं ये सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट? सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट नहीं है.
नहीं, वो नागपुर वाला संघ बदल
खत्म कर दो
सर.
नो क्रॉस टॉकिंग प्लीज.
ऑनरेबल प्रेसिडेंट हैज मेंशनड अबाउट इन पारा 64. दिस इज अ सब्जेक्ट विच इज डियर टू यू, डियर टू मी, डियर टू मेनी ऑफ अस. वन नेशन वन.
आई थिंक नाउ इन अनदर टू मिनट्स
यू डोंट वांट मी टू कंप्लीट दिस.
नो नो, यू हैव टोल्ड 10 मिनट्स, नाउ 8 मिनट्स इज ओवर नाउ.
तो थोड़ा और 10 मिनट.
नहीं नहीं, ऐसा नहीं हो सकता.
वेरी वेरी
विदिन 2 मिनट्स यू प्लीज कंक्लूड. आई अंडरस्टैंड
हैज सेड. आई मीन बाय दैट आई हैव अनदर 2-3 पॉइंट्स सर. वन नेशन वन इलेक्शन. जॉइंट कमिटी ऑल्सो हैज गिवन अ रिपोर्ट टू द हाउस. Deliberation discussion also is in the media and also outside. And I had requested, and my bill is also before this house, private member bill, that how to have one election, both Lok Sabha and respective Vidhan Sabha, and how we can have it. And here, sir, I would say we need, the president has said, constructive debate on simultaneous conduct of elections in Lok Sabha and state legislative assembly. Sir, Prime Minister also is quite enthusiastic about it. And that's a very good thing. We spend a lot of energy, lot of time, lot of money. When you have different elections every year is an election year, and our house also gets disrupted also because of these elections. I don't know, we have another 3-4 days in hand. If something happens tomorrow or day after somewhere in some state, again house also will be in a different mood. But some also say simultaneous polls are against spirit of faith. But Odisha has shown it. When there is a northerly wind, the pressure from Bay of Bengal also can withstand that northerly wind, and we can win. And that's why Biju Janata Dal could win. Especially the eastern coast from Bengal to Tamil Nadu, even to a great extent Kerala, we could withstand the northerly wind. So why should we presume that if there is a one election during for Lok Sabha and Assembly? Today, sir, in our state the panchayat elections are being held. A voter goes to the polling booth. He knows whom to vote for ward member, whom to vote for sarpanch, whom to vote for panchayat samiti member, and whom to vote for jila parishad member. On a single day, in the single room, there are 4 ballot boxes, and he casts votes. And all votes are not identical.
Please.
And why should we believe,
Mehtabji,
that Indian
honourable member, please.
Please, sir, give me some time. Why should we believe that people are so foolish that if they are voting for a party for the centre, they will also make an identical vote for the province? It may have different.
UP will be different.
Yes. Sir, another interesting suggestion also had come from one of our members who had written an article that as in United States, why not we have 2 different type of voting, one for the parliament and one for the all state assemblies. But I think it is high time today that this house also should deliberate, the election commission also should participate, and we have to frame up our mind.
Election Commission has
given a suggestion for the political parties to take a decision. But I think that initiative has to be made, and it is better. The quicker it is, the better it is, sir. Sir, the last point which I would like to mention here is relating to a CAG report. Report number 25 of 2016. In this report, because this deals with, it has some connection with the Honorable President's speech, sir. And this deals with pahal. And this deals with give up. कितने सारे slogans आ गए हैं. Give up.
Give it up. Give it up.
Thank you. Give it up. And in this, sir, I'll just read it out. IOCL, I'm reading it out on from report number 25 of 2016, and which is under, I think, the consideration of Committee of Public Undertaking. I think so, because this is a report which will go to that committee. Nothing to do with my committee, sir. Or a committee in which I am a member. IOCL, the coordinating agency of OMCs for LPG, considered the average subsidy rate in 2014-15 while working out the subsidy savings for 15-16. This has led to an overstatement of savings in subsidy. In view of the sharp fall in 2015-16 vis-à-vis 2014-15, if the average subsidy of 169.45 rupees per cylinder in 2015-16 was considered, as used by Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas in their estimation, and after considering the savings in subsidy due to opting give it up by 67.27 lakh consumers, as on 29th February 2016, the subsidy savings would reduce to 3,473.48 crores instead of 5,107.48 crore estimated by OMC. The actual subsidy, this is the...
Please conclude, Mehtabji, please.
The actual subsidy payout, I think you are going to make a judgment on this.
Yes.
The actual subsidy payout during the period from April 2015 to December 2015 was 12,084.24 crore as against 35,400.46 crore during April 2014 to December 2014. The significant reduction, this should be underlined, the significant reduction of 23,316 crore in subsidy payout was on account of the combined effect of decrease in offtake of subsidized cylinders by consumers and lower subsidy rate arising from the sharp fall in crude price of 15-16. Audit examination indicated that reduced subsidy rate on account of fall in crude oil price resulted in reduced subsidy payout of 21,552 crores, while the effect on the same due to reduced offtake by cylinders by consumer worked out to only 1,763 crores. Therefore, it is evident that the lower subsidy rates in 15-16, by far,
okay,
the most significant factor result in subsidy. It is not 21,000 crore, as it has been mentioned here in 2 years.
No, okay, point again, aapka. Please conclude. I have to call Anandra Vadsul now.
ये कुछ समझ में आ रहा है कि नहीं? मैं समझ नहीं पा रहा. This is something which the Honorable President has stated before the joint session, in the joint session. And here, who has given this information to the Honorable President? अगर CAG कह रहे हैं कि 1763 करोड़ है, और इसमें कहा जा रहा है कि टोटल गिव अप, गिव इट अप इज 21,000 करोड़, दो साल में 1763, और कितना होगा? आई वुड ओनली सबमिट सर.
थैंक यू.
बिफोर द गवर्नमेंट आई वुड ओनली सबमिट सर, इसका क्लैरिफिकेटरी नोट आज ही नहीं चाहिए.
आनंदराव अड़सुल जी,
हाउस को इसके पूरा ब्यौरा मिलना चाहिए. बिफोर कंक्लूडिंग सर, अगेन आई वुड से Mahanadi water dispute is a glaring example the neglect this government, union government, is giving to Odisha. transmitting out to Odisha.
Thank you.
It is time now that Prime Minister should intervene, and immediately the tribunal should be formed, because this year in 1718, India is going to face El Nino. Drought situation is looming large. This year the kharif crop will not be there.
Thank you. Anand Rao, please start now.
Sir, last line, sir. Just last line is here. Water is going to be a major problem in our country. We have a water resources standing committee. We had an all member committee relating to water. But water is a genuine problem today in our country. And there is a need today. We cannot shrug away our responsibility saying that we don't have power. Water is a state subject, no doubt. But there is time, there is a necessity today that all political parties should sit together, and when there is a interstate dispute, in most of the states, water is a dispute.
Right, thank you. Thank you.
It is necessary.
Anand Rao Arsulji, please start now. Now it is your turn.
अगर मेरे को भी तुम 5 साल बिठाते तो जरूर करके दिखाता था। अरे ठीक है, मेरी बात हो गई। मेरी बात जब बोल रहे हैं तो मैं बोल रहा हूं। मैं